Hare Krishna. We have gathered to observe the disappearance day of His Divine Grace, Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj. Tamal Krishna Goswami was a very powerful servant of Srila Prabhupada and older brother to almost all of us in the Hare Krishna movement, except for a few devotees. He was senior in years in the movement and in association with Srila Prabhupada. And he really took care of us like an older brother in all respects. So it is very appropriate on this occasion that Tamal Krishna Goswami's very dear, devoted, and devout follower, Mohini Madan, has put together a collection of remembrances of Goswami Maharaj by his godbrothers as an offering for his disappearance day. Srila Prabhupada has explained for a Vaishnav, appearance and disappearance are the same. He gave the example that both the sunrise and the sunset are beautiful. So in the same way, the appearance and disappearance of a Vaishnav is also beautiful. And therefore, we don't lament on the occasion of his disappearance, but we celebrate his continuation of his devotional service to Srila Prabhupada and Sri Sri Radha Shamsundar in the next place. And we who are left behind have the opportunity to remember him, offer our homage to him, celebrate his life in service, and express our appreciation for all that he did for us and for Srila Prabhupada and for so many fallen souls.
Tamal Krishna Maharaj was one of the most brilliant disciples of Srila Prabhupada. During the early days, Srila Prabhupada's main assistant was Tamal Krishna Maharaj. Practically in every important front, he was there to lead Srila Prabhupada's mission. When the movement started to expand in the West Coast, Tamal Krishna Maharaj became the president of Los Angeles Temple. Then when the movement started to spread in England, George Harrison and John Lennon became attracted to Srila Prabhupada's teachings. Prabhupada sent Tamal Krishna Maharaj to spread the movement in UK and then to Europe. And then the movement started to expand in India. Srila Prabhupada made Tamal Krishna Maharaj the governing body commissioner of India. And then during the final pastimes of Srila Prabhupada, when he just retired from everything and withdrew into Vrindavan, into his intimate Leela, Tamal Krishna Maharaj was the one who was with him, taking care of him in all respects. And then after Srila Prabhupada's disappearance, Tamal Krishna Maharaj led this movement in a very, very expert way. Then for some years he actually withdrew and went into his academic pursuits. And then when he completed that and was about to come back to the field of preaching, all of a sudden Krishna just took him away. At that time, our feeling was, why Krishna took him away at such an important time? But then, of course, we had to recognize that Krishna is the completely independent personality, the supreme personality of Godhead. So he must have his reasons for taking him away. And I personally feel that Krishna took him to another planet, another realm, another area where Srila Prabhupada is spreading Krishna consciousness, and he felt that there is a need for Tamal Krishna Maharaj to go there and assist Srila Prabhupada there. So we are actually dealing with eternal involvement as servants of Krishna. So there is no end to that service. One may depart from one planet, but that is not the end. We have to recognize that in some other spheres, or maybe in the spiritual world itself, he is engaged in Krishna's service in a most remarkable way, as he always rendered his service. And we hope that someday we will be together again at the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada.
And I am eternally indebted for his contribution to my spiritual life and to my broadening my perspective of Srila Prabhupada, of our movement, and of many different aspects that,
At one point, maybe a year or two before, I was talking with Dhammakana Swami about ISKCON, and he said, ISKCON may have its ups and downs, and we all have our characters. He goes, but what would ISKCON be without its Tamal?
Ramakrishna Goswami was very instrumental in establishing ships. He was known for being very frank, very to the point, no fluff, no beating around the bush. He would just cut to the chase. When there was something that needed to be said, he would say it.
He embodied the principle of Guru Nishtha, the devotion to one's spiritual master. It's something that he learned, no doubt, in the personal association of Srila Prabhupada. All of his accomplishments and all of his considerable intelligence and determination and other qualities that we hear about him, I think they followed from this very basic, essential realization. Every year that without his association, physical association, I feel this more and more and appreciate everything that he did for me personally and everything that he contributed to this movement. In some sense, I don't think it would be an exaggeration to say that he really contributed to the lion's share of what we know as ISKCON today by the grace of Srila Prabhupada and through the agency of his pure devotion to Srila Prabhupada.
I went to the American Academy of Religion for many years, which is a huge international conference, mostly people from North America who are scholars of religion and study Hinduism and Buddhism and all these things. So I've been going for some years as a communications person. When Tamal Krishna Maharaj went back to the university, he started coming. And the first year that he was there, that I was also there, I remember him seeing me and asking me, I want to speak with you. Kind of a very firm tone. I want to speak with you. He said to me, why are you here? And I was a little, put back in that. I was, honestly, my first thought was, well, what are you asking me that for? I've been coming here for a few years. What are you asking me? But the senior Vaishnava sannyasi is working on his PhD, still senior to me in so many ways. So I just I said, well, actually to learn something. He said, that's the right answer.
We were in Mayapur the year when he left this world, and then this extraordinary thing happened that this one devotee, Padmalochan Prabhu, who was one of our god brothers, he was walking out of the temple in Mayapur right after we heard that news, and he looked up into the sky and he saw a vision. This was maybe at about 9 o'clock in the morning, something like that. And he looked up into the sky and he saw a vision of Srila Prabhupada with his danda and Tamal Krishna Goswami with his danda, and Prabhupada was was pulling him by the hand and saying, come on, you have to come. And Tamal Krishna Goswami was saying, no, I have so much to do. I have so many projects to complete. I can't go now. And Prabhupada was just saying, yes, you have to come now. And just pulling him. And then they just disappeared up into the sky.
I would like to share with all of you something which is very dear to my heart. When I was very small, maybe 12 or 13 years old, my mother took me to a big department store in the town of Hamburg. She said, we will have to choose some birthday gifts for your older brother, and you know what your older brother likes. So we went to the center of the town, we arrived before the department store, and there, as the snowflakes were coming down, was a small group of devotees who were chanting. They did the Swami step, like this, a famous Swami step, and chanted the Hare Krishna mantra. I was fascinated. I had seen them maybe once on TV when the German TV announced the new exciting group which was produced by George Harrison, the Radha Krishna Temple. And I was at that time very much fascinated, but I had never seen them live. I had never heard their song live. And I stuck to them. I was glued on the spot until I felt my mother tugging at me and saying, let us go. We have to choose birthday presents for your older brother. So she took me up, but I could not forget what was going on downstairs. So I told my mother when we were in the children gift shop, or that level where the gifts were, mother, I have to go to the bathroom. And my mother knew. She said, okay, then go to your nonsense people. So I went down and I stood before the devotees and listened to them chanting until I marked one devotee who looked very effulgent, and I took all the courage I had and approached him and said, can you give me the lines of the song? And he spoke back in very broken German. Yes, do you have a pen and a paper? I forgot. Maybe he had, or I had, or I went to someone of the passers-by. At the end, I ended up with him writing down the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Then I took that sheet of paper and I went home and I forgot about it until I secretly looked one Saturday in the third channel. There was a horror movie. I was forbidden by my parents to look at horror movies, especially not when they were sent in and emitted in the midst of the night. But my parents were out somewhere at a big conference. The house was, there was no one there, so I had the key to the television and I looked at Frankenstein. And when I had seen everything, I was so afraid. As I was coming back to my room, I was constantly thinking Frankenstein is behind every corner of the apartment and of our apartment in our house, and would come out, and I had to pass the bathroom, and I thought, he's for sure in the bathroom, and now when I'm passing he will strangle me to death. Then I came back into my sleeping room, and he is for sure hiding here. I did not find the sleep I needed until I remembered there was this one free from all miseries. So I took the lines out, and as I was reading them, I saw in my childlike mind a memory of that devotee coming like the moon into the darkness of my material existence and handing me the Maha Mantra. Only much later I found out this devotee was His Holiness Tamakrishna Maharaj. So this is how Tamakrishna Maharaj came very early into my life, gave me the Maha Mantra. I chanted that night under the blanket, and at the end I felt transcendental bliss. This gift of the Maha Mantra I owe to Srila Prabhupada and to his servant Tamakrishna Goswami.
When he had an idea to do something, he wouldn't, you know, give it up. We were serving him in the Calcutta, under him in the Calcutta temple in the early days, and he was a great organizer. Calcutta temple was very hard to live in. It was a difficult time. Tamakrishna Goswami had to organize and manage different affairs, and to do that, there wasn't even an office for him. So actually in the veranda he built a small office, and it was known as the Blue Office. He painted it blue and because of lack of space. So he just figured out ways and means in difficult situations to make to continue his service to Srila Prabhupada. So we're indebted to him in so many ways.
He left behind a legacy of appreciation and respect.
He was the first one in my life to introduce to me to Srila Prabhupada. But the most intense moment came at the later stage. He came and hugged me. Because he was very appreciative towards me, that I was trying to help his disciples in Fiji. So I had a feeling of gratitude.
Tamakrishna Maharaj would not spare any pain to try to facilitate any desire that Srila Prabhupada had. It was very wonderful to see that although he was such a great personality, that he relished, you know, this, you know, being corrected and being chastised and being fully loved by Srila Prabhupada. He took pleasure in a description that Prabhupada gave of him, that he was a desperate man, meaning that if Prabhupada gave him an absolutely impossible engagement, something that no one else could do, then by hook or by crook, Tamakrishna Maharaj would be desperate to get that service done. Every time I drive to Mayapur along that road, I think of Maharaj, and I feel a sense of lamentation that Maharaj is no longer here, you know, to assist in guiding myself and helping to give guidance to the International Society for Krishna Consciousness. But I pray that Tamakrishna Maharaj is guiding us from above, and I'm sure that in the hearts of all of his sincere friends and all of his sincere disciples, he's guiding them, engaging them, and encouraging them in the spirit of pure devotional service to Krishna. So thank you very much, and Tamakrishna Goswami Maharaj Ki.